With me here in the studio this morning from IXICO, I'm joined by Alison Howie. Alison, morning.
Good morning.
You've had an update out on your contracts and two new clients.
That's right, yeah.
Who are they?
Lots going on. These are new clients for us, biopharmaceutical, but particularly biotechnology companies. I think, you know, in previous updates, we've mentioned that's a growing part of our business. So really exciting to have two new clients from that space coming on board, both focused on rare diseases and neurological conditions. So again, an expansion of our portfolio and expansion of our therapeutic areas for more growth.
And so these will be earlier stage trials, will they?
They are. One is actually slightly later stage, and it's an asset that's been licensed from another company. So I think, again, that sort of speaks to the dynamics in the market where there's a lot of horse trading going on, a lot of in and out licensing, both from larger companies who maybe have assets that they don't want to pursue. The biotechs are coming along and taking those to market and through clinical development. But equally the other way around, where we're working with a lot of biotech companies who have early phase assets that they're then trying to license to the biopharmaceutical for commercialization. So it's an interesting time to be in the space.
Indeed, and these two new studies, these are worth how much to you?
They're worth combined just over 1 million.
Wow.
And you know, obviously smaller size studies, but they're actually over a much shorter period of time. That's one of the reasons they're smaller studies in terms of value. So in terms of making an impact, they have a much bigger impact in the shorter term.
And getting involved in these earlier stage trials opens up that potential to do the later stage trials.
Absolutely.
With these companies as well.
Absolutely, and that's been a really successful part of the company strategy for many years now, is to work on earlier phase, develop the biomarkers, validate the biomarkers with the client, and then those biomarkers and the approach to evaluating the asset continues to later stage pipeline. Mm.
And an existing study that's been expanded, has it?
That's right. So this is one of our larger studies, a late phase study, which again has been expanded. And we see this a lot in the market, where clients either decide to recruit more patients, or they may expand in terms of adding additional sites or additional geographies. But in this particular case, it's additional patients that they're looking at. But also we also see that they may see the value of the work that we're doing and expand to look at additional analysis pipelines later on to gain more insight from the data that they've already collected.
Now, what more can you tell me about the study that's been discontinued?
So again, this is sort of part and parcel of working in the CRO space. We're contracting with clients, we're helping them with their clinical development. Sometimes that works and they carry on all the way through. Sometimes in this case, they had an interim review and decided that on the basis of the results that had been collected so far, it wasn't worth carrying on. So really, I mean, the core part of our value proposition is that we're helping clients to de-risk their clinical development. And I think this is another example of where that, obviously it's disappointing for the patients who are involved in that study, very disappointing for the client and disappointing for us. But it's a normal part of doing business in the clinical development space.
Clearly not a reflection on IXICO here.
No, absolutely not. And we're working very hard with the sponsor right now to close out that study, to complete the analysis, because ultimately, all the biopharmaceutical companies are collecting data and sharing data with the community. So even the work that has been done so far, although this asset won't go through, the insights that we've developed and the data that we'll provide, data analysis that we'll provide, will still go on to influence future studies in the space. So it's still valuable. It's a normal part of doing business.
And what about impact on revenues?
So near term, we don't see any impact this year. As I say, we're still working with the client to close out that study. Longer term, the bulk of the 3.5 million that we mentioned in the release was actually scheduled to be delivered in the sort of 2022 to 2025 period. It's an open label extension. So much longer term, obviously it's disappointing that we've lost that from our order book, but near term we've got a lot of good things happening in the pipeline that obviously we've announced in the here, but more to come.
Well, so across the board then, business is good?
Business is good. We're doing a lot of good stuff, working really hard with our clients, and delivering a lot of really good analysis and science with our clients. Building new partnerships with academia, which again we see as a really strong part of our strategy to develop greater understanding of what's happening in these conditions.
And you joined as Chief Commercial Officer 18 months ago?
That's right, about 18 months ago. And you know, I've 20 plus years in the life science industry, always working in with scientists and always on the commercial side. So a lot of good stuff happening at IXICO.
And IXICO, a good team to be a part of?
Absolutely. I mean, it's a relatively small company, but it enables us to be very agile. And I think that's what our clients value in us, that we can provide a lot of flexibility. We're doing working with them at an early stage and helping them, as I say, to de-risk their trials and adapting what we've done in the past and building on our track record to deliver what they need for the future.
Good to see you, Alison. Thank you.
Great. Thank you.